Kamal, that's Ciarán Corda, and Minister, can I first say, you know, politics can be a difficult game and can be a harsh game. We in the Labour Party, and particularly myself, don't see it as my job to make you feel uncomfortable over the next number of years. In fact, I want to be in a position to congratulate you as often as I possibly can, because I think there are certain issues in Irish public policy that go beyond the over and back Punch and Judy show politics, and education should be one of those. And we are in a situation, historic situation, where for the first time in the history of the state, there was a question mark over the Leaving Cert, and also a question mark over the schools opening in September. And I don't believe that happened during the Second World War, and I'm pretty sure that it was a mammoth task that you considered it to be when you took over your role. So on that basis, I do feel you are deserving of congratulations, and your department are deserving of great credit, that the schools are opened, and that the really dangerous part of the assessed grade system, the school profiling, that you did listen. Now, there are two different types of opposition speeches and, you know, opposition politicking. One is when you come into the chamber hoping that what you're raising won't be adhered to by government, because then you can keep complaining about it. And you put down sometimes an amendment to legislation hoping that government won't adopt it, so that you can keep giving out about it. And there's a different type of opposition when you raise something that you genuinely, earnestly hope that the government will take on board, because it comes from a place of deep concern and understanding. And in fairness to you, Minister, we raised the school profiling issue again and again and again and again, and it was with great joy a number of days ago when we learned that you had listened to concerns that were made and had acted upon them. And I think that is the type of politics that does this House some credit, and I want to thank you most sincerely for the moves that you have made, and indeed for taking on the responsibility of opening up our schools. Now, there are obviously going to be issues over the next couple of months, Minister, you appreciate that, and we're not going to agree on everything. And perhaps we won't even agree on most things. But at the same time, I think if we are determined to work in some capacity together, we might actually achieve some things. Now, I know that many schools were not really in a position to tell the true story of the difficulties they were having, because every school runs on the basis of reputation. And if you start telling the world that you can't open your school because of lack of space or whatever, it could potentially reflect poorly on you. And every school, every September, is worried about numbers, or many schools are worried about numbers to keep teachers, to keep resources, etc. So it is, there can be a conspiracy of silence sometimes, where schools are so determined to keep their reputation going that they will soldier on and not put their head above the parapet. School transport is an issue, Minister. It falls between your department and the Department of Transport. We need a dedicated unit so that members of the Oireachtas or schools or school boards of management can access a dedicated unit swiftly and in order to get answers to the transport questions that are arising. It has been said that we need to keep not just open schools, but keep schools open. The testing regime for teachers, for SNAs, for school staff, for secretaries, for caretakers, is something that has been prioritised by teacher unions, and you are responding to it. At the briefing that we heard earlier today, Minister, I raised the issue, as you know, of those who are over 16 years of age and therefore have no legal requirement to be in school. And I was comforted and satisfied that the answer that your department officials gave, that you are aware of this issue, of the potential for a lost generation of young people, and that you're alive to that fact, and that resources will be made available to schools in order to ensure that no young person is lost from the system. But the final thing I'll say in this matter, is that what COVID has done, just like in other areas of the economy and other areas of Irish society, it has ripped open the plaster of deficiencies within the system. The relationship between the department and individual schools, the fact that this department does not like to engage in today's day management of schools, the amount of autonomy that are given to school boards of management and patron bodies that really should be the role of the department. These are historical constitutional matters, Minister, which I want to raise within Citizens' Assembly on primary and secondary education, which I know you have committed to in the programme for government. But with that, Minister, we are determined to work with you to find solutions. There's been enough distress and uncertainty and chaos and tears over the Leaving Cert and over the school system over the last number of months without politicians adding to it. We do need to talk about Leaving Cert 2021 and what last year's, this year's, sixth year's students are going to face into, because I think we have to have some recognition within the system of what of the difficulties they had last year and what kind of system we put in place for them. But with those comments, Minister, I hope you take the Labour Party's bona fides at face value, that we do genuinely want to find solutions.